There have been many discussions this week over the language used to describe the events in the Capitol and at the Capitol building. NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker has more.
It's hard to find the words to describe what happened on Wednesday. Was it a riot? Was it an insurrection? It certainly was more than a protest. It's often said that journalism is the first rough draft of history, but how will the words that we choose to describe what happened in Washington this week impact the way America remembers?
Even just to describe the attack on the Capitol, are they rioters? Was it a mob? Is it terrorism? Is it insurrection? Is it a coup?
Joanne Freeman is a professor of history at Yale University who specializes in the politics and political culture of the revolutionary and early national periods of American history. She's written extensively about turmoil in American politics. As a historian who studies journalism and history, what does the coverage look and sound like to you, and what do the words that are being used sound like to you?
In many ways, I think Americans don't quite have the words to describe what's going on. This morning, I saw some people referring to what happened on Wednesday as the storming of the Capitol.
Supporters of President Trump stormed the complex. The angry mob burst through barricades and police.
And I actually object to that. Storming romanticizes it. There's nothing romantic about what happened. It's not just born of passions, you know, noble passions. It was an act with implications and repercussions. It was an attack on the government. In all of these ways, it's not just a peaceful expression of passion.
Yet passion is a word often used.
We gathered together at a moment of great division, at a moment of great passion.
Senator Ted Cruz reaching for it on the Senate floor as he lodged objections to the state vote certifications on Wednesday.
So speaking as a historian who's always interested in the meaning of words in the past, in the right context, we're in one of those moments that, you know, 50 years from now, historians will look at us grappling to find the right language to talk about this moment. There have been a lot of words being thrown around that are being thrown around more as buzzwords than as words with meaning. And some of those words are pretty significant ones. So, fascism, socialism, communism, even democracy, liberty, freedom, patriotism.
Looking out at all the amazing patriots here today, I have never been more confident in our nation's future.
We're in a battle of words as well as a battle of politics, particularly when you have extreme circumstances like we're experiencing right now. Those kinds of words can be used as masks to mask extremism, right? This is democracy. This is liberty. This is freedom. Now, here's the thing, and it's going to sound obvious, but I think it's important to realize in a democratic form of government, you know, a democracy is grounded on public sentiment and public opinion. That's really basically where the power is. A pronouncement made from on high, meaning the national stage, a congressman, a president, those words have added meaning, and those words can be taken, are almost always taken seriously by some of the public.
The words and the way the words are being used are also being used, I assume, to recruit more amongst the far right. For instance, I'm thinking of tweets that we saw, Instagram postings of revolutionaries inside the Capitol, patriots taking back the people's house.
Right? Revolutionaries. People are grabbing at moments in the past out of context and using them to frame what they're doing, right? This is supremely American. Our revolutionaries did it. We are just like them. That's what we're doing. And on the surface, you can happily sort of nod along with that. If you actually look at the reality of what happened during the revolution and what happened now and what these people are doing, no, that's not an easy comparison to make. And the problem with that, and this is the problem of propaganda, how do you disprove that, right? I can say people who attack the Capitol aren't patriots. That's unpatriotic. What do I say if someone says, no, I feel very patriotic. I'm defending government as I see it. These words are powerful for a reason because they're hard to refute. They're fuzzy and they have a gut impact and a profound political meaning. Now that leads to another point, which is there has to be accountability in a broad way right now, because if there isn't, the message is clearly, well, that was fine. That was okay. And why, if you were someone who engaged in that kind of behavior and there's no impact of any kind and there's no consequences, why would you not do that again?